Hello, it's Keith here. Something a bit different today, isn't it? Well, I'm playing this little DOS game I used to have when I was much younger. It's called Grime, and it's a very simple game we had on the PC1512, which was an early PC made by Amstrad, actually. Why am I playing this? Well, it's a bit of practice and research, if you will. I'm actually planning on remaking this game for the Z80, because it's quite simple, it's quite fun, and I think I can do a good job of it. Well, why am I doing such a simple game after I've done Chibi-Akuma's? Well, I'm planning something quite dramatic. I've booked 7 days off work. I'm going to spend those 7 days on a sort of programming stretch, if you will, and I'm going to try and make a version of this game in those 7 days that will compile on 10 different systems. Now that's the ZX Spectrum, the MSX2, the Amstrad CPC, the Enterprise, the Sam Coupe, the TIE 83, yes, I'm supporting that thing, the Game Boy Color, the Gamegear, and the Sega Mastersystem. Now, I suppose you could argue whether the Game Boy and the Game Boy Color are different systems, but I'm going to treat them as different ones because they got different color capabilities, and also the Game Boy Color is a faster processor. Now, the reason I think this is going to be quite interesting is, firstly, it's going to be the first time I code in my programming tutorials using the Game Boy and the Master System and the Game Gear. And the reason I'm sort of doing that is I want to get up to the same standard of programming ability on those systems as the other systems I use, and I really need to do some serious coding to do that. But also, this is going to be one program that can cross-compile to 10 different computers, even though they've all got quite substantially different capabilities. So this is going to be a sort of a proof of the ability of my programming tutorials, because of course the code will be based on the tutorials code, and it will also be a great starting point for anyone who wanted to create their own little simple game that used basic graphics and sprites, because you'll have a template that does all of the sprite rendering, the input reading, etc., etc., and some basic sound effects. And I think it will be a fun little project, and also that the result will have useful benefits in sort of educational purposes. So as you can see, it's a relatively simple game, but it's a lot of fun. You have to keep this grime at bay, which eventually overpowers you, and then you explode like that. But yes, I think this will make a nice little Game Boy game, or a nice little TIE 83 game, which is a tiny system. And I'll be sort of, as I say, doing this over 7 days in early July. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to do a video blog every day of just the update of how it's going, and I'm going to post those in sort of real time on my Patreon page for anyone who's backing me on Patreon. If you're not a Patreon backer, don't worry, because it's going to be made public. I will post them one a week, probably on Wednesdays, because people on YouTube tend to like regular updates but don't tend to like being overloaded. So I'll post one a week, and then once the, assuming I finish the game, and I'm sure I'll end up with something, and then once the project's ended and on the last video, I will link the source code and the game compiled code, so you can play the game if you want and have the source code, and of course we'll discuss how it works. So I'm hoping people will follow me for this, because I think it'll be a bit of fun, quite a nice little game, and as I say, we'll along the way we'll gain the experience of creating one game for 10 systems using cross-compilation. Most of them will compile with WinApe, except for the Game Boy version, because the Game Boy processor isn't a true Z80. It's often from time to called a GBZ80. It's got some limitations, but I don't think they're going to stop me from making this game on that system. So thanks for watching today. I hope you'll stick around and follow me for that.